Hi, my name is Johannes and I'm a product owner at Tesla. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you create and set up the OPC UA certificate sensor, which enables you to monitor certificates from OPC UA servers, which is a crucial part of your OPC UA infrastructure. Have fun! Okay, let's start right away monitoring our OPC UA server certificate. As usual, we start by selecting a device. In our case, it's the back of IPC. And we add the sensor using the add sensor dialog as usual. There we go for OPC UA. And then you see a bunch of sensors already available. In this case, we focus on the OPC UA certificate sensor, which you can see here. And as it says, it monitors the certificate of an OPC UA server, and that's what we want. Quite easy to add, no settings needed. So we proceed. And just wait until we have the values available, which is now happening. So what you basically see in the sensor is first the sensor message, and here you get the certificate common name and the certificate thumbprint. So you can already compare it to the certificate you install on the device to see if it's the proper certificate. Next, we have the self-signed channel, which in this case is yes, or could be also no. As default, PRTG has the self-signed certificate lookup, so you can change it on your requirements if you want to get an alert or not, if it's self-signed or not. If you install the sensor right away, both cases will be green, yes or no. Then we show the public key length of the certificate, also with a threshold added, basically. So if it's too low, then we get a proper error. But you can adapt it, of course, as usual, to your requirements. And the last channel, and probably the most important one, days to expiration. So in our case, we have 7,000 days left, so it's quite a long time. But if you're in a more secure environment where you exchange certificates in a shorter time frame, then it's pretty handy because you can set a proper threshold there. So per default, it's 28 days for warning and 7 days for error, which means if the certificate runs out in 7 days, you get a proper alert to replace your certificate. Because if you do not do that, probably it might lead to a production stop or an issue on the devices because they don't trust each other anymore and don't communicate. And that's basically everything you need to know to set up a proper monitoring of your certificates for OPC UA. I hope you really found this tutorial helpful, and if so, please give us a like or consider subscribing to our YouTube channel. Also, leave us a comment for feedback or any other topics. And if there are any questions, always ask us at support@pesla.com. Thanks for watching.